Hello students, today we will discuss about the formation of rainbow. Rainbow is a bow of seven colors formed during rainy season when the rain is stopped and the suspended water droplets are in the atmosphere and there is a bright sunlight. In that situation, if this happens in the morning, then rainbow is formed in the west. And if situation is in the evening, then the rainbow is formed in the west. It is always formed opposite to the direction of the sun, and always the person who observes the rainbow, he finds the rainbow in front of it, and behind the person there must be sun. So basically rainbow is a phenomenon of spectrum of light due to the phenomenon of spectrum of seven colors. Okay, spectrum of seven colors that we get due to the phenomenon of refractions and dispersion of light. So, like the meaning of rainbow, is a phenomenon of spectrum of spectrum of light, spectrum of white light formed in the sky from the sky due to the phenomenon of reflection, refraction and dispersion of light. Dispersion of light. So now there are the There are two types of rainbow basically. One is a primary rainbow, the other one is secondary. The primary rainbow and the secondary rainbow. We'll discuss that one by one. Let us first discuss about primary rainbow. Excuse me. So we have suspended water droplets in the sky. Let us consider one such droplet. This is a water droplet. Water droplet. Now the light coming from sun, this is sunlight, enters the droplet. So there is a refraction. So because it is a sphere, this is a normal, this should be the normal. Therefore, instead of going straight, it bends towards the normal, so it bends like that. Bends like that. Bends towards the normal. And because of total internal reflections, it is reflected like that. And again, dispersed from here into seven colors. starting from here, that is your V, and this is your R, and the person says V to R. The V1 is the person who is observing this here is the person is observing this. Obviously, this angle is less than this angle is more. This is 40 degree and this is 42 degree. What is that? The ray is first refracted at this point. When it enters the water droplet, it enters at this point and undergoes a refraction. So there is one refraction here. Then here at this point, there is a total internal reflection. This is reflected back following the laws of reflections. Then again, there is a dispersion over here. This is dispersed into 7. So there is a when the dispersion is happening, there is also a refraction. So here, two times refraction is taking place in one time reflection. And the person who is observing this rainbow, the arc or the bow like, you'll see that this 7 colors like that, starting from V and to R. So it will give your last one is this. So we observe, the observer observes like this. This is a rainbow. It is in the form of arc. Okay. Now, the primary rainbow, there is one internal reflection, and for primary rainbow, we will note a few things. There is the ray undergoes one total internal reflection, as you can see here. And two refraction times, and the angle the violet color makes with the horizon, or the minimum deviation of red color with the sun rays. Okay. This makes an angle of 42 degree, and the violet color makes 40 degree with the sunlight. The minimum deviation, the deviation of the minimum deviation of the red color is 42 degree. This is minimum. And this minimum deviation for the violet color is 40 degree, as you can see in the diagram, with respect to the sunlight, with the horizon, or with the horizon. So when we see the arc form like that, then what angle it makes with this horizon, that is your angle. So the violet obviously is from, so is seen here first, then we move up, then we see the red one. So obviously the red one will make greater angle with respect to the violet color, but because the rainbow is very far off, so the angle subtended is very less. So between the those two extreme colors of violet and red, violet and red, so the difference hardly comes out to be, you can see, 2 degree. So if we see the violet color over here, then the red will be just above it. So that much difference. This is very like thin, like so there is not much angle it can subtend on the eye because it is very far off anyway. So this is the thing, and the order of the color you see is here. So starting from V, we move to R. Okay. So you have total internal reflection, two refractions, and the colors are making such angles with the ray of light. Now, in case of a secondary rainbow, the situation is slightly different, but it's a rainbow. The ray enters like that, goes like this. There is a refraction over here, first refraction, and here total internal reflection, total internal reflection, then 1, 3, so 2 and 3 are internal reflections, 4 here refraction, it comes like that. So the red and violet, see from here below, this is, you see from here, and so the order of the observations or the colors are reversed. Earlier it was V, B, Vior. Now it is just the reverse. The first color you see here is red. So right to Vior from here to here. Like that. So then you see orange, then you yellow, see yellow, green, blue, indigo, and this violet. The violet color is seen at the top. Basically, when it's rarely seen, but seen that first you get the primary rainbow, and then above it you get the secondary rainbow, because the primary rainbow starts with V and ends with R, and just after that, with the R, you start the secondary rainbow, that is, starts with R and then moves off and ends with violet. Here, the angle that this angle of deviation for this red color in this case is 52 degree here. This is 50 degree, see, and the violet color makes an angle of 53 degree. So you can see here, in case of a secondary rainbow, the angle of deviation here is more in case of violet, because you have to look violet at the end. The start is your red, so angle is more, and order is also reversed. So a few points you can note down for this, that there are the two internal reflections, total internal reflections, and two refractions taking place, and this is a water droplets. Water drop, and the angle the violet makes is 53 degree, and the red makes is 50 degree. Okay, so with the horizon, and fourth one, the order of the colors are reversed. Here it is R reversed. So in this way you see the rainbow. Okay, it's formed above the primary rainbow basically. So first you see primary rainbow, 7 colors, and ends with red. Just after that, here start the secondary rainbow, ends with violet. This is the secondary rainbow. Sometimes seen very carefully if you observe in the sky after rain, you might observe that primary rainbow. Okay, this is all about the book. Thank you very much.